please be very clear. All your activities are centered on you, what you think as you. For example, if you think you are Raman, you think Raman, Raman's husband, Raman's wife, Raman's daughter, Raman's family, Raman's property, Raman's spiritual growth, Raman's physical body, Raman's mental health, Raman's economical status. Whole thing is centered on you, but you don't realize the very Raman is not there. You are trying to continuously protect yourself physically, mentally, or emotionally, economically, spiritually, or socially. But the very being whom you are trying to protect is not there. Understand this one beautiful simile. This actually happened to me as a darshan, as a vision, experience. From this only I created our emblem. If you see our emblem, the Paramahamsa is our emblem. Paramahamsa Pakshi is our emblem. Paramahamsa flying in the sky is our emblem. I had a beautiful vision or experience. From that only I created that emblem. How the human life happened on the planet Earth. The great swan, which never comes down to the planet Earth, it is just flying in the sky, floating, enjoying and expressing its freedom, expressing its own bliss. In the lake or a pond, the reflection is there. The reflection of the swan is there in the pond. The fishes in the pond thought, oh, the swan has come down to the pond. They started playing with it. They are enjoying with the swan. The fishes are jumping on them, on the swan, on this side and that side, on the shadow of the swan. There are some fishes, they start fencing. This is the boundary. This is my swan. This is my swan. There are some swans started purchasing the neighbor land, neighbor real estate. The swan may come here. Already the real estate is developed. There are some fishes. No, I am the brother of the fish. I am the brother of the swan. I am the son of the swan. I am the wife of the swan. The whole drama is happening. Suddenly, the swan has just started flying on the land. On the then suddenly, the swan has moved. The shadow or the reflection which was appearing suddenly disappeared. Immediately all the fishes started crying. Hare, what happened? Our swan has disappeared. What happened to our swan? But they never understand the swan has never landed on the planet Earth. The whole thing is just drama. Same day, you have started thinking you have a soul, or what you think as soul, you have soul that is different. That soul is totally different. Whatever you understand as your soul is not your soul. Then you started protecting. There are so many fishes. All the fishes are also you only. You started creating fence for you. You start first assumption that you have soul. Next, you wanted to protect that soul. Create house. Create relations. Create social security. Means wealth. Create all these things. And then decide, oh, I need spiritual growth also. Then go to some guru. Go through the Mysore road, and which is which board will looks very bigger, are nice, are beautiful, enter into that ashram. Start searching for spirituality also. But you forgot the very swan has not happened. There is no swan. You are just playing with the shadow. Suddenly you realize the swan has disappeared. Swan will not even know what the drama the fishes are doing. Sometimes the fishes start cursing the swan. What is this? Building in this swamp, we built such a beautiful house and we raised all the real estate value around these buildings. Now each flat is going for 5 lakh. And suddenly, they realize the swan itself is not there. The swan will not even know all the drama which is done by the fishes. Same thing is happening in your life. Your soul don't even know all the dramas done by your body and mind. The soul doesn't even know how much your body and mind is suffering unnecessarily. Because it never landed on the pond. Whatever you are seeing is only a pure reflection. If you can meditate on this one story, I tell you, you will be liberated this moment. If you can keep yourself only this one understanding, only this one understanding, just like a Zen koan, this is Ananda stories. This one story, you have never happened as you think. Whatever you think as you is not you. The root of you, based on which your whole thing is moving, the very root is non-existence, Nibbana. Nibbana means Nirvana, which is non-existence. But to protect something which is non-existence, you are torturing yourself so much. Do whatever possible day. Simply your body is undergoing this change. Your mind is undergoing this change. The stream is flowing. If the fishes are trying to push the stream, or if the fishes are trying to stop the stream doesn't even know. Whether you try to become enlightened or you try to be against the enlightenment, God doesn't even know. All the fishes thought, let us stop this stream. Let's have a barricade, hold our hands each other, stop this stream. If all the fishes stand in the stream, if they try to stop the stream, do you think they will be successful? Stream will not even know the fishes are trying to stop it. Same way, you not becoming enlightened, or you not realizing, your Atman doesn't even know that. Even that much you are not connected to your being. So whatever you think as you is just non-existent. Yes, your question. Whatever, all this, 3 days I was working, 4 days I was working, is superficial way. But unless that load is reduced, this you can't understand. Whether you cleaned it or not, they are not even related. First of all, there is no impurity. Where is the question of cleaning?
What's the way forward then, sir? What's the way forward?
The moment you ask the way forward, you spoil the whole teaching. Over. Now whatever I have spoken is just waste. It has not happened in you. You have not heard it. If you hear properly, what is the need for way forward? Still, if you are asking for the way forward, simply the realization will guide your life. Don't ask the hypothetical question, once I realize this, what will happen? Beautiful. One born blind man went to the doctor. Doctor said, I'll do an operation, you will have your eyes back, then you can walk without stick. The stick which they use, the blind people, they use the stick to feel. The blind man said, Master, I understand, Doctor, I understand you'll do an operation, I will have my eyes back. But how can I walk without stick? unless you have your eyes, you cannot understand how you can walk without stick. Intellectually, you cannot be convinced. Till you get your eyes, you can walk without stick. Understand this one thing. Look inside. Whatever you thought as you is not there. And it will not be there. Just it will not be there. Whatever points are the base for your suffering, where the points are rooted, that very root is non-existent. The very root is non-existent. That is why I tell you, your name itself is non-existent. That is why in Zen they say, meditate on your face before your birth. Just visualize how your face was before your birth. Can you visualize? Then what? Just 50 years ago you are non-existent. Whatever you think as you are non-existent 50 years ago. Am I right? And 50 years after you will be again non-existent. Why are you then suffering so much? Why are you torturing yourself just for this few years of drama? The whole thing is just nirvana. Whatever your ideas, what society will think of me, that's one of the important big trouble, what others will think about me. Meditate on this one sutra. Don't bother what others are thinking about you, because they are bothering what you are thinking about them. Don't bother what others are thinking about you, because they are bothering what you are thinking about them. It is just a drama happening continuously, because you don't have time to stop and look. You don't have time to open your eyes and see. You don't have time to relax few minutes and watch. You are also involved, because your TV was never switched off even for 2 seconds. You never thought the TV can be switched off, or there can be few moments when scenes will not disappear, scenes will not appear. The screen will be empty. Here I am trying to tell you, just because the screen is continuously filled with scenes, don't think what you are seeing is truth. It can be switched off. You can switch off. You can relax. It is time, at least for next half an hour, relax, meditate on the face which you had before your birth. Now, when I say, directly try to hear, what you understand is enough. For my words, what your dictionary says, that is enough. Just refer your Oxford dictionary, that is enough. Whatever words I say, just refer Oxford dictionary, and what you understand, that much of understanding is enough. I am not speaking anything metaphysical. I am not speaking anything big spiritual. I am just using the word which you can directly refer with the Oxford dictionary and understand. That is enough will liberate you. I have always seen, there is a beautiful story. When Ramakrishna was alive, people used to go and tell him, when Chaitanya was alive, we didn't have a chance to see him, otherwise he would have become enlightened. Ramakrishna says, when Chaitanya was alive, people go to him and say, when Krishna was alive, we were not here. If we have seen Krishna, we would have become enlightened. Ramakrishna says, the people who sat in front of Chaitanya, and spoke about Krishna, as saying, because we have not met Krishna, we have not become enlightened. The same group only is sitting in front of Ramakrishna and speaking about Chaitanya. And the same group only will sit in front of me and speak about Ramakrishna. It is here and now. If at all something can happen here and now, just understand the very base which you think as you is anatta, doesn't exist, changes every moment. That is why your needs are different every day. Today something is tasty, tomorrow something is the same thing is not tasty. When you lose your balance, no, like this, how can it happen? You try to tell yourself, no, that is tasty, but mind is not ready to believe. You are just changing. How much you try to make you feel comfortable, how much you try to tell yourself, no, I exist. I am consistent. There is something which is under all these things, alive. Again and again, truth comes up. You experience the vacuum, nothingness. But the nothingness creates a tremendous fear in you. It shakes you. Wow, where am I going? What am I doing? What is this Swami teaching me? He is taking away the basic root on which I am standing. He is just shaking me. Of course, if you are afraid that I am shaking you, I will take my hands, Maya will shake you, that's all. If you understand, gracefully you will go beyond. Or Maya will just snatch you from you, that's all. Whatever you think as you is just tumor on your system. It is not you. If it is you, the very being will be totally different. The very being will be totally different. Of course, what I am speaking, I don't know how much you will be able to receive, but I am speaking, at some point when your being is ready, these seeds will start growing. I am just sowing the seed. When you are ready, these seeds will grow.